Welcome all of you to this particular session of least common multiple and highest common factor. And we are going to see certain illustrations where the idea will be clear. We have already gone through the video of the concept. Now the idea will be basically cleared through the illustration, including the application. Let's see how we go about. Yeah. The first numerical is find LCM of 20, 24, 36, 54. Now, 20, 24, 36, 54. Now, we have to find out LCM of this. LCM is what? Expanded least common multiple. That is, it is essentially common multiple and minimum out of it. In order to find common multiple, best way is to factorize all this thing. Let's see how we factorize all this thing. 20 is 2 into 10, 2 into 2 into 5. So we factorize till all the factors are prime. So we get 2 into 2 into 5. 24, 2 into 12, 2 into 2 into 6, 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. So we factorize till all factors are prime. Then 36. 2 into 18, 2 into 2 into 9, 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Check. We find all the prime factors of the number. Now for 54, 2 into 27, 2 into 3 into 9, 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Now, if we find out all this thing, we are supposed to find out the common multiple. That means, what is the common multiple for 20, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100? Common multiple of 24, 24, 48, 72, and so on. Among these common multiples, we have to find out which are, how many of them are common. Find out the multiple of 20. Find out the multiple of 24, 36, 54. And out of all the multiples of the four numbers, find out the common multiples. Among common multiples, whichever is the lowest one will take as LCM. So for that, the method is very simple. We try to factorize all this thing into prime factor, which we already done. Now what we realize in this, 2, 5, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3. So total distinct factors in this is 2, 3 and 5. So what we do, we try to express the factors in multiple of 2, 3, 5 and their powers. So what we'll do, look here. Now this is 2 into 2 into 5. Can I write it like that? This is 2 to the power 2 into 5. Can I write it like this? Yes, we can proceed ahead. Then this factor is 2 raised to 2, is 2 raised to 3 and 3 raised to 1. So can I write down 2 raised to 3, 3 raised to 1. Here the factors are 2 raised to 2, 3 raised to 2. I'll write down 2 raised to 2, 3 raised to 2. Now here it is 2 raised to 1, 3 raised to 3. 2 raised to 1, 3 raised to 3. What I have done? I have simply obtained the prime factors, then express in the powers of the prime factors. I have expressed it. Then I would like to make all the factors appear in all the factorization. So what I do? I will put it equal to 2 to the power 2. In this there is no 3. So what I'll make the 3 appear and have a power raised to 0. So 3 to the power 0 will be 1. So I am not affecting the correctness of the problem. And then I have 5 to the power 1. Look here. 2 square into 5, same thing I am writing, but I am making 2, 3 and 5. All the 3 factors appear in the description. 2 to the power 2, 3 to the power 0, 5 to the power 1. Can I handle them similarly? Look here. 2 to the power 3, 3 to the power 1. Now here there is no factor 5. Here there is no factor 5. So what I will do? Multiplied by 5 raised to 0. 2 to the power 2, 3 to the power 2. 2 to the power 2, 3 to the power 2, and 5 doesn't appear here. So 5 raised to 0. Now here, 2 to the power 1, 3 to the power 3, and 5 to the power 0. You understand? Now what we have done, we have obtained first of all factors which are prime. Then we have expressed the factors in their powers. And then we have expressed all the 3 factors, 2, 3 and 5, let them appear in a factorization procedure of all the 4 numbers. If they are there, well, put it. If they are not there, we'll put rest to 0 and make them appear and nullify. So we get this particular structure. Now, LCM is product of highest powers of all factors. LCM is product of highest powers of all factors. Means what we are going to do? Look here. Now, it is 2 into 3 into 5. So, I have already written the factors. Now, I have to write the powers of them. Look here. Power of 2 here is 2, 3, 2, 1. So, highest power of 2 is 3. So, I write down in LCM 3. Then, I have the power of 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. So, highest power is 3. So, I'll write 3. Then I have power for 5, 0 and 1. So I have to write 1. What I have done? I have taken factor 2 and obtained all the powers of it. Highest will appear in LCM. Highest will appear in LCM. Highest will appear in LCM. So LCM is this. So practically LCM is 2 to the power 3 is 8. 3 to the power 3 is 27 into 5. So practically it is 40 into 27. How much it is? 1080. So LCM of 20, 24, 36, 54 we got as 1080. Let's see the illustration. Similarly, we have handled the thing and illustration goes ahead with. Can we see the next example? We'll go for the next example. Yes. Now we have seen LCM. Now let's see HCF. Now in HCF also, same method can be applied. Same method can be utilized. What we do? It's a highest common factor. So we'll try to factorize all the numbers first of all and try to put and express them in terms of different powers of all the distinct factors. Let's see how we go about. Same process is advantageous. Let's get it illustrated. Look here. Come. As already the board is having an entire thing, factors of 20, factors of 24, factors of 36, factors of 54. Are available here. However, in HCF what happens? In HCF it is the lowest, HCF is product of, instead of highest, it is lowest. HCF is the product of lowest powers of all the factors. HCF is the product of lowest powers of all the factors. So what I will do? I can always remove the powers. Are you understanding the structure? The distinct factors are 2, 3 and 5. So I have put 2, 3 and 5. I am yet to put the power. For highest common factor, I have to take the lowest power. Look here, power of 2 is 2. 3, 2, 1. So 1 happens to be the lowest among all. So I will take the lowest power. 2 to the power 1. Look here. Now, 3 to the power 0, 3 to the power 1, 3 to the power 2, 3 to the power 3. Among this, 3 to the power 0 happens to be the lowest power. So, I take 3 to the power 0. For 5, 0, 0, 0 and 1. So, 0 happens to be the lowest. Are you understanding? For LCM, we take highest power. And for HCF, we take lowest power. We have taken the lowest power and resultant answer is 2. 3 to the power 0 is 1, 5 to the power 0 is 1. So, answer is 2. So, HCF of this is 2 and LCM is 1080. Now, I'll try to compare this. I'll try to compare how it goes about. I will compare this. Okay. Now let us analyze the LCM and HCF with respect to the numbers. Let's see, we have HCF, which is smaller than all the numbers, and LCM is bigger than all the numbers. HCF is smaller than the smallest number, and LCM is bigger than biggest number. Now, if I would like to put in terms of the factors, can I put it like that? HCF 20, 24, 36, 54, LCM. Now, I will express all of them in terms of powers of distinct factors 2, 3 and 5. So, can I write it loud like this? 2 into 3 into 5. 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 Okay, last. 2 into 3 into 5. All factors common. Now, I'll look for the 20. In 20, it is 2 into 2 into 5. So, 2 square into 5 raised to 1. So, 3 raised to 0. 24. It is 2 into 2 into 2, that is 8 into 3. So, this we already seen in the last one. 36. 36 is 2 into 2, 3 into 3. So, 2 into 2, 3 into 3 into 3. 5 raised to 5 raised to 0. 54. 54 is 2 raised to 1 into 27. So, and 5 raised to 0. Now, what we do? The lowest in this, I put in HCF. The highest in this, I put here. The lowest in this, I put here. The highest in this, I put here. The lowest power I will put here. The highest power I will put here. Over? Understood the procedure? And understood the concept. Now, why it is HCF and why it is LCM? Look here. Now, if I consider the factors of it, when I say 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 3 is a multiple of 2 raised to 1, is multiple of 2 raised to 2, is multiple of 2 raised to 3, is multiple of 2 raised to 2. When I look at all the 4 numbers, I am only restricting my analysis to the factor 2. Same analysis I will use for factor 3. Same analysis I will use for factor 5. And same analysis is true for multiplication of the factors, powers of the factor 2 and 3 and 5. Let's see what the analysis. Now, 2 to the power 3 is a multiple of all the factors of 2. 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 2. All these factors can divide 2 to the power 3. So, 2 to the power 3 is multiple of all. So, can I say this is common multiple? Then how it is called as least common? Understand. Suppose I am having power 2 to the power 6. It is also divisible by all of them. So, this is also common multiple of all of them. If I consider 2 to the power 9, this is also common multiple of all of them. So, can I say 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 6, 2 to the power 9 are all multiples of all of them? Are you getting it? However, 2 to the power 3 happens to be the minimum out of this. So, 2 to the power 3 is the lowest or least common multiple. Common multiples are all of this. 2 to the power 3 is the least one. Now look at HCF. HCF is highest common factor. Means what? This is a factor. This factor divides all this thing. Look here. Look here. 2 to the power 1 divides this. So 2 to the power 1 is a factor of this. 2 to the power 1 is a factor of this. 2 to the power 1 is a factor of this. 2 to the power 1 is a factor of this. So 2 to the power 1 is a common factor of all of them. And it is the highest common factor. What could be another factor of this? Can I put 2 to the power 0? If I put 2 to the power 0, 1. 2 to the power 0 means 1. Now, 1 is a factor of all the number. So, 2 to the power 0 is also a factor of all of them. So, we can say that 2 to the power 0 is a common factor. 2 to the power 1 is a common factor. So, between these two, 2 to the power 1 happens to be the highest. 2 to the power 0 is lowest. 2 to the power 1 is highest. So, highest among common factor is highest common factor. So this concept is basically with respect to what is applicable. Look here. 3 to the power 0 is highest among the common factors of this. And 3 to the power 3 is the lowest among the common multiple of this. 3 to the power 6 is also multiple. 3 to the power 9 is also multiple. Among these common multiple, 3 to the power 3
is the lowest common multiple, and so on. So this is the conceptual illustration of LCM and HCF. Let's go next. The solution is mentioned there. Go ahead. Yeah. LCM and HCF of numbers 100, 132 and 330. Methodology is same. What we do? I put here 100, 132 and 330. Let us factorize it. Let us factorize this. This will be 2 into 50, 2 into 2 into 25 is equal to 2 into 2 into 5 into 5. Simple factors. We factorize till it becomes lowest prime factor. Now, come down over here. Let's see how it goes. We go ahead with the illustration. 132. 2 into. Now, this will be 66. 2 into 66. So, this will be 2 into 2 into 33 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 11. So, these will be the factors. See for 330. 2 into 2 into 165. Then we can this is again having factor 3. Why? 1 plus 6 plus 5 is 12. So sum of the digits is divisible by 3. So the number is divisible by 3. Divide by 3, 3 into how much it will be? 2 into 3 into 5 into 11. So we realize that the distinct factors are for 100, 132 and 330. I can also put here HCF, LCM. Now you'll appreciate with the previous example illustration that these are having common factors 2, 3, 5, 11. 2, 3, 5, 11. 2, 3, 5, 11. Same will be the factors of HCF and LCM both. So I'll get 2, 3, 5, 11. 2, 3, 5, 11. Now talk about the powers. Look here, 100. 2 to the power 2, 5 to the power 2. 2 to the power 2, 5 to the power 2. 3, 11 are not there. So powers of 11 and 3 will be 0. 132, 2 to the power 2, 3 to the power 1, 11 to the power 1. 5 is not there. So 5 to the power 0. 330, 2 to the power 1, 3 to the power 1, 5 to the power 1, 11 to the power 1. Very simple, you can easily understand this. Now, the power of 2, if I consider 1, 2, 2, highest is 2, lowest is 1. Highest is 2, lowest is 1. Highest we put in LCM, lowest we put in HCF. 1, 0. 0 is lowest, highest is 1. 0 is lowest, highest is 1. 0, 2. 0 is lowest, highest is 2. 0, 1. 0 is lowest, highest is 1. Can you understand this? Now we express it in terms of 3 to the power 0 is 1, this is 1, this is 1. 2 to the power 1 is 2. So HCF will be 2. HCF of this will be 2. And now LCM, make a power. We can make it out. 2 to the power 2 is 4 into 3 into 25 into 11. If you simply make it like, look here how it goes. 25 into 4 is 100. 25 into 4 is 100. And 11 into 3 is 33. So 3300, I will immediately get 3300. So LCM of all these numbers is 3300 and HCF is 2. So this is the way we go ahead with LCM and HCF. So many examples and applications will be there. You are required to solve some home assignment as well. See to it that the same concept is being illustrated in the factors which are ahead. And we are going to get more application example where the concept of formulation will be there and the concept of solution will be just like this. Once we understand the basic concept of LCM and HCF, then we have seen the illustration of LCM and HCF, then question comes in how we apply them in real life application. Thank you.